Good morning. Today I'm going to take you into my classroom and show you a particular lesson that we are working on right now. And I will turn the camera around and show you. So this is the photo of a student. This student will be putting his photo on a grid and drawing it. He will have an assessment. He's going to draw it in black and white. We use a posterized version of his picture. And he will end up drawing it backwards. Why, you say? Because when we lift this off, we can turn it over and put it on good paper, and it will transfer. We will rub it on the back with pencil, and there will be no grid lines. So this is his picture posterized. I try to give my students a lot of reference, a lot of help. I tell them that if they can get the values right, then the rest doesn't matter, that the color is not as important. I talk to my students about cross-hatching, and we do parallel hatching, then we do contour hatching. Let's see if I can get contour hatching in the page. Then we get cross-hatching and fine cross-hatching. So I believe these are helpful to understand how painting works, because if you can paint well, or if you can draw well, you can paint well. So to begin painting, we learn how to use value. And we do a value study using the 9 values. This is only watercolor. And then we do several shapes and learn to shade it with paint. I tell my students that painting is drawing with paint. And that's it. So this is the first part of my series, and we will be going from here. One more thing I will show you is, I have my students do a plein air head in gouache. Let's see, I'll go back a little bit. And in watercolor. So then they can choose which one they want to do their portrait in, the plein air head. They can draw it out themselves, which I prefer, or they can just transfer it and start. When I tell them to use gouache, the main things that I want them to know are written on here. You want to put it on thin. You want to let each layer dry, or use a hairdryer. You want to start with the darks, then the lights, then the midtones. Save the highlights for last. Then they want to prepare for an ugly stage when they're blocking in colors, because it will get ugly. And then too much water will lift the layers underneath. You can blend by removing the excess water from your clean brush and blend out the edges with your fingertips. Thanks for visiting me in my classroom. This is Prof. Robson. Bye-bye.